everybody. Dave Anderson, Harborside Marine, in balmy Clinton, Connecticut on this March 25th. Just in, used 2012 Sea Hunt 27 Gamefish. Beautiful load right trailer. Comes with the boat. It's got the electric winch. It's even got the electric jack stand. Okay, moving forward. Big, huge Carolina flare like we all know Sea Hunts are for. This one's done in beautiful black. It's got a custom boot stripe on it. Beautiful hardtop, custom name. I mean, you like the name, you keep the name. You don't like the name, you get rid of the name. It has all brand new brake hardware on it, calipers, pads. He also went and polished the trailer, which is astounding. This thing is 100% ready to go. It is ready to fish tomorrow. The hull could use a good buff, but I think it'll come back real nice. It's pretty shiny the way it is. Twin 150 Yamaha four strokes with 850 hours. Just barely broken in. These guys were super meticulous about their maintenance on the boat. There's not a scratch on the skegs anywhere. All the zincs are done. This boat is turnkey ready to go. Lenco electric trim tabs. We also have underwater lights on this baby. All right, custom touches. You got your guide poles on the fender with extended brake lights. Let's get up into the heart of it. Okay, when we get on the boat, we walk through this beautiful transom door. This is pre-Sea Hunt side door entry, okay? This was the down and dirty offshore fishing machine. Huge kill box here. Cutting board on top. Live well over here. Big live well. All kinds of big. This does have the flip-up bench seat. Nice and wide, stick three guys on there, no problem. Over here, we have the Gamefish 27 Battle Station. Huge live well, cavernous. And it is lit, as is the transom one. Also, you have a little mini sink here. Your fresh water for your sink. There's a little pull-out shower nozzle. That, apparently the handle's broken on, but you get the idea, and I can fix that in 2 seconds. All your assorted plugs to hold everything. Another cutting board on top. Positive latch. Tube storage for your squid jigs. Plier storage. Hook storage right here. Okay, moving forward. Check out this little coil system they did for the raw water washdown. They plumbed in a flex line and then they added it to your coil and it's neat and tidy and taken care of right there. Very nice addition to the boat. Full hard top, rocket launchers here and on the back of the helm seat. This is Sea Hunt's standard helm seat with the battle station for 2012. It's nice. It does, in all transparency, as you can see here, does have a little pinking, but structurally it's just fine. Standard Horizon VHF, Yamaha digital gauges. This boat has 850 hours on it. Has Garmin 5212, which is correct for the year. Tilt hydraulic steering. Okay, this is very interesting. This is how they used to do this before about 2015 when they went to a different style hardtop. But this is Stratoglass. Okay, this stuff is indestructible. Keep it clean, it'll last you forever. Gull wings, isinglass, close all this off. Run offshore in the fall with no problem. Halogen spreader lights for the rear deck at night when you're fishing, you want to see what you're catching. LED lighting up in the top of the console here. It does have a fresh water system with misters. Okay, we already talked about the electronics. This is kind of a neat add-on. I've never seen this before, but it's kind of slick. So what they did was they pulled out the radio faceplate and they modified what's like a piece of Tupperware. But guess what? That thing's as nice as it was the day it was put in the boat, almost. Not going on 10 years now, okay? So, kind of an ingenious little thing. I've never seen it before, but I kind of dig it. Okay, we talked about the Garmin. It does have radar. 18-foot telescoping outriggers. Wide open e-box up here. If you wanted to add an extra screen for just proprietary fish finding, 100% doable. Compass, glove box down here. Extra key in there, that's nice. Little well here for extra stuff. Drawer storage, again, fresh water system. Can't have enough storage, especially if you're fishing hard. Okay, moving forward, we're gonna take a look inside the console. We've got all our bow seating cushions in here. Okay, also your battery switches are right here on the inside. Access to your electronics. Okay, and a full porcelain freshwater fed head with a holding tank and a macerator. Okay, if you're out legal area, you can just dump your dunnage right over the side. Okay, forward jump seat right here. This is a fixed cushion, it does not come off. The reason we don't put a well here, like most manufacturers have either a removable cushion or a flip-up cushion, so we have all that under here for inside dry storage. All your expensive fishing gear, life jackets, whatever. However, this boat is also equipped with a life jacket holding bag on the forward section of the hardtop. You have a forward spreader light here, lights up this entire foredeck at night. Windlass, nice feature. Another change from this era of Sea Hunt to the newer ones. The newer ones come with a through the stem windlass. This is just as effective. You have controls for it on the bow and at the helm. I guess that's about it. This is a nice boat. It will not last. It only has, again, 850 hours, barely broken in, bulletproof 150s. It has the right electronics, and it has the right hull, and it's in spectacular shape. Again, I'm Dave Anderson with Harborside Marina. We'll see you out on the water.